$30,000. Angela won the toss. We'll ask her to go first.
I'm going to go with AC.
All right. You got it. Og. Og. The caveman. Is speaking. This is what he says. He says, I just saw the world's silliest animal. It's a saber-toothed lion. Silly. In the spot, Roger. Stick it in. Yep. Angela. Todd, the caveman. You know him, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
From the paleo literature. You said, I just saw the world's silliest animal. It's a saber-toothed blank.
How about dinosaur?
Would that be crazy? Oh, no. What came to your mind, Roger?
Not a lot. But I try to imagine something with a big tooth. I went small. I went for a saber tooth.
Well, that's good. Very good. Saber tooth mouth.
Yeah.
You got the idea now, Angela, right?
A little late, but here we go.
Well, I thought it would be fun for a lamb, but I...
That would be good.
Yeah, because it's so gentle.
Yeah.
Saber tooth lamb. You put mouth. That seems to be the response.
The oldest
creature I know of on this planet is, and I see them on my beach in Cape Cod all the time, is a horseshoe crab. The scientists say they have not changed in form or shape or anything for millions of years. Isn't that interesting?
Only it's okay.
Not on this panel.
Constance, are you with us?
I thought this would be funny, but not right.
I think it's quite amusing.
Yes.
Saber tooth chicken.
Is it funny?
Yes, it's funny. You don't know if I'm funny, I'll tell you when to laugh.
The
roast
is the oldest
living
thing on Earth. The roast is? That's it. It's the oldest living thing. And, you know, I have this diet, longevity diet.
Oh, yeah?
It's nothing but scattered crumbs while crawling along the counter. But, now what did you say? A saber tooth dinosaur?
Dinosaur.
I thought you said dinosaur.
I wrote. All right. Now, Sally, let's see what we have for you. Here it is. The scientist is speaking, Sally. And the scientist said, the telescope is terrific.
Oh, God!
Come back after your voice changes. It's terrific. Not only did I see a flying saucer, but I could read the bumper sticker. It said, warning, I brake for blank. This telescope is terrific.
No, Philip, I was. I just don't know whether these research towers are closed or not.
I don't know that much about Tom. He's just bothering me.
Oh, yeah. I met him recently.
Recently?
You know what he said to me? He says, hi, Gene, it's nice to meet you. We're talking about Tom Selleck. He said, you know, in the 70s, when you were doing the Mets game on that other network, I was a starving out of work actor watching the show every day. Great show. That's what Tom said.
Well, that too is interesting. My funny guy.
Okay, Sally. Scientist said this telescope is terrific. Not only did I see a flying saucer, but I could read the bumper sticker. It said, warning, high brake for blank.
Naked lady.
Naked lady? I like your spirit, Sally. What a funky answer. She said naked lady.
I thought she said naked.
Unlikely that we're going to find any naked ladies here, but we must poll you anyway. Roger?
Coffee, break, coffee.
Aha! Coffee break.
Coffee break, coffee.
Oh, Roger, you're...
Coffee, break. That's no better than naked ladies.
Don't encourage that sort of thing. Phyllis?
Well, he said fine, Roger. I just pretend.
Top death! There's a little touch of humor. Top saucers, you get it? Oh, dear me, these headaches. Death. Oh, there we go again. Real tears.
Did you remember my last edge? I thought I was older, but I said little bunny, the sweet little bunny.
Yes, right, little bunny. That was your last answer. You break four.
I break the sweet little birdies.
Sweet little birdies who are flying around in... Now he's going to get violent, and he's going to walk right in that audience, and you're going to regret it if you agitate him anymore. All right, John, go and tell.
I drink first.
Ewa. All right. Everybody's getting silly. Constance?
No, Ewa. I drink for Meteor.
Meteor. That's a good one. Miss Penny?
I break for the flying nun.
Aha! So now, we've had the round one question. You got those out of your bowl, right? All right. Round two coming out right after this. So round two coming up. Okay. Let's see, the score tied. You went first last time, so Sally, you're up this time.
Okay, I'll go for A, please.
You go for A. All right, you got it. Old man Periwinkle said,
I never should have gone out with Ron
After 20 minutes under water, bed, I needed blank.
Your train of thought, but I don't know if that train of thought occurred over here. What do you say, Roger?
Very attractive.
They are indeed.
Very attractive, yes. Very attractive. However, in the batting department, we're batting a thousand leads.
CPR, mouth to mouth. All right? Good. Hello, darling.
Hello, darling.
Love your outfit.
I had my teeth up bronze.
You had your teeth up bronze?
And this is something I love, mouth to mouth.
Yes, of course. All right.
I hope they're not looking for the shower curtain in the dressing room.
The paramedic. I needed the paramedic. All right. There are a lot of good answers to this.
What do you got?
It was a waterbed.
A waterbed.
After 20 minutes in the waterbed, you needed a lifeguard.
All right.
I think I got a peek at Thompson's answer, and hers is a very good one. Idea of dressing up like Blaine.
I got a lot of money now.
You got to match somebody.
All right.
Very fancy. Here we go, Tanner. Fancy Reagan says, Ronnie, dear, I know you want to deal with the youth of the nation, but are you sure it's a good idea of dressing up like Blaine?
Boy George.
Boy George. Good one. That was indeed one of the
I know the kind of woman you are. Yeah, England, Boy George. Yeah,
Boy George.
One for Angela.
Phyllis?
I'm so sorry. A Boy Scout.
A Boy Scout. All right, Charles.
You know, I wouldn't write an answer like that. First of all, I'm on a show with an MC that's wearing a Boy Scout, and this guy over there is wearing an earring. Boy, rubs me the wrong way.
What'd you say?
Huh?
Come on. All right, Butch, what do you say?
Look out, your pedals will fall.
Michael Jackson! All right. Michael Jackson and Boy George are the two good answers, Jack.
Like that?
What'd you write?
Boy George.
All right, that's two good answers. Constance.
I'm with Charles, Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson. So there we are, round two, 3-0, Angela's favor, round three, the final round, right after this for you. Angela, where do you go first?
Well, there's two A's in Angela, so I'll go first.
You want A? A for Angela, she says. All right. Waldo is speaking. Waldo said, it isn't easy being married to a motorcycle cop. On our wedding night, he gave me a ticket for blanking. Waldo's wife is a motorcycle cop. You understand that?
Now, which one is
this? This is for Angela.
This is for Angela.
Okay, we looked up here.
right, Phyllis? Well, give it to Phyllis. Ready. Here we go.
Wallace said it isn't easy being married to a motorcycle cop. On our wedding night, she gave me a ticket for blanking.
Speeding?
Speeding is good. Speeding? What do you say?
Oh, I finally became a winner.
You are a winner. Speeding. Ford Angela. Charles. This answer is for David Trim and Ted Gonzalez. The two motorcycles. She's up to five. Now we come to Constance.
Hello.
There it is.
Now, Sally, you have one shot at it. The best you could do is tie, but you can do that by matching everybody. It's been done many times before, so listen carefully and give it your best shot. Rodney Dangerfield said, there's no respect. Last night I came to bed, my wife said, not tonight, dear, you have blank.
She's asking for his phone number now, but you can call him and find out if he's out in the news. Where is he? Is he in this hemisphere?
He's in Canada.
He's in Canada.
What's he doing up there? Here we go. Sally. Rodney Dangerfield said, I don't get no respect. Last night I came to bed, my wife said, not tonight, dear, you have blank.
Bad breath.
Bad breath?
Yeah.
All right. Have you ever said, not tonight, dear, I have a headache? You never said that.
Oh. Okay.
Roger, we need everybody over here, Sally.
I wonder if this night's been made. Well, at least you're a fat-ass woman. You're always going to be a winner. But they always say, I have a headache. I feel no respect. You tell them, he's had it.
Not tonight, dear, you have a headache.
All right, what the rest of you have?
Job of interpreting the match game question. Three and three, total. Six matches, you've done perfectly. And you're moving right on to Hollywood Squares. Three brand new celebrities, they are Leonard Fry, Barry Gordon, and Roxy Roker. Leonard?
John.
yesterday you treated us to a demonstration of your tap dance.
Cards and letters have been falling in.
You were wonderful. Now, what is it?
Where did you take this? Just a guess. The cards and letters have been so encouraging. I would like to reciprocate all over you by just a touch of my military cap.
Oh, please, please. Oh, yes, okay. The Julia Child recommends the Zinfandel to go with your whopper. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
Recommend the Zinfandel to go with your whopper. You should have agreed with Phyllis and your phone against that trip. No perfect record so far. Two questions to Mrs. Sarah. Try to break the trip.
Ten flags.
You've got a cold. But you want to kiss your boyfriend goodnight.
Yes.
What should you do first to reduce the germs in your mouth?
Yes.
Take two aspirin, or eat an onion.
This is Friday. I have to do well. I have pressure. Germ. Okay. You want to eat an onion?
Eat an onion. germs in your mouth, what do you say, Tara?
Agreed.
In order to reduce the germs in your mouth, you should eat an onion.
You should have a serious good fatty. The perfect drink is intact, and your pony gets that square as well. Eat an onion and help you sterilize your mouth. Where is the boyfriend? I would go right to the call. Okay. We'll be back to complete a $100 game after this.
Don't get it.
Stay tuned for more of the match game. Hollywood Square Flower.
Leonard Fly is the real name of Roy Rogers. You should have disagreed once again, guys. All right, sorry, you have blocked there, and now it's your turn to try to break this meeting. Just get yourself.
Thank you.
All right. The first right answer of the day would give you the guess.
Very
good. Yes. You're a woman executive.
Don't
know. Well, next question. Pretend you're a woman executive.
All right.
In the middle of a heat wave.
Yes.
And the air conditioning is broken. According to Glamour magazine, is it okay to show up at work without your pantyhose? Or must you wear pantyhose no matter how hot you are?
Well, do you think I got as far as I did as a woman executive by having an EG? I mean, do you? No. I had to wear my pantyhose in all kinds of weather.
Because you must wear your pantyhose at all times of your visit to the car for the game.
I agree.
You must wear your pantyhose. So it's going to set the square. Yeah. Your pet bird can feels dry and warm. Is he about to shed his skin? Or is he dead?
Feels dry and warm.
He's got a fever, obviously.
Is he dead?
I'm asking you.
I know. Shedding his skin or is he dead?
Right.
Why did he stop? My earth one isn't dead yet. But I think he's dead.
So the earthworm feels dry and warm, he's dead. What do you say, Angela? He's dead. You're right. You're free. You're all right. Tara, pick a star for next. Gene Rayburn was
nice. You're on a roll now, John.
Hey, sure. While visiting Russia, will leaving a tip in U.S. dollars guarantee you'll be treated well? Or is that against the law?
Well, I haven't been there, and I have no intention of going and enriching their coffers.
God bless you.
Wait a minute. Here. Staying in this country. Well, I don't know. Money is a universal language, and things are so tough over there. I would think that American dollars would be welcome. Maybe against the law, but it would be welcome.
So you're saying that leaving a tip in U.S. dollars will guarantee you to be treated well?
I would say so.
Da 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 da
da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da
da da da da da da da da da
da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da da.
Buy a big cucumber. According to the Supermarket
during the fall.
By the 30 seconds floor, it's all over.
Agree with the three angles for the game. You're more likely to die only after you hit the ground.
No,
Here to play the Supermatch is Gene Rayburn. write down your best answer to this.
Cab.
Blink. If you give us the answer they chose most frequently, we give you $1,000. For the second most popular, $500. And 250 for the third. And let's see what sort of suggestions you're going to get from the start.
Ten. Okay. Cab driver.
Cab driver. Selection last starter, reveal a number and multiply your $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. And there are 410, 420s, and 130 up there somewhere. Whom do you choose?
I'll pick Jonathan.
John? All right, last time you picked it, he had a 10. Well, nobody knows where it is. It's not a close random. All right, you're random. Here we go. Good luck to you, Tara. Here it is, John. No help, please. Blank. Dot. D-O-T. Blank dot. John's ready. It's up to you to collect the $20,000 by matching him. What do you say to that? There's one really terrific answer to this. I suspect John may have it. We'll find out right now. I don't think he's going to have Mike or Doc, though, but that's what I've learned. I actually got that on the spot kind of fast because I'm not going to say the first thing that came to your mind. First thing that came to my mind.
Polka dot, yeah. You know, Polka, it was kind of, that's really the best answer, but it was kind of hard to think of that, and I'm sorry you didn't, but you picked up another couple thousand bucks. You now have $13,050.
Per box. Feed your youngsters with refreshing Popeyes. Hot air, champagne. Here come the Olympics. The Los Angeles prepares for the most spectacular premiere in its history. City officials have many hurdles ahead, such as security for 8,000 athletes and marathon traffic jams. Correspondent George Lewis is